not gonna die on the first level. Twice. Yeah, I lied. First game to run at 60 FPS? I mean, every NES game runs at 60. Thanks, Dio. This game basically runs at the highest resolution the PS1 can output, but only because there's not a lot of detail to take up memory. Yo, thanks, Jaxor. How you doing, man? Yeah, this is hotness, that's for sure. Yeah, I will say, looking at this game on the TV, does give me a headache after a little while, so. It's not a game I could just play for like 3 or 4 hours. First 3D game run at 60 FPS. Might be able to jump. Well, Jumping Flash is the first 3D platformer to run at 60, although it doesn't run at 60 very frequently. It does get to 60. Unlike a game like Crash 1, which never gets to 60. Thanks, Microwave. I really should not read chat while I'm playing this. No, I didn't. Well, I mean, I should correct that statement. I did not get a new time. I can talk louder. I'm talking kind of quietly, so I can maybe just talk louder too. should be is monkey and then tiger and back to monkey. If I'm murmuring to myself, I went through and I typed out on notepad the weapon route I want to use. Because there are 12 weapons in this game, and for like a vast majority of the run, you really only use like two of them, but there are a few select situations where others are good. That's mostly what it says. In some of the later stages, you do use a few of the other weapons. Not many of them, though. Some of them never get used, bro. And you think of at least four that I don't use at all. I was gonna be like, I don't know how I didn't die there. I didn't do this right. So good. Yo, what's up, Punchy? Yeah, this song slaps. Oh, I just wasn't even, I didn't even see that. Alright, we're just gonna keep going. I'm just gonna finish the game. Because I haven't played through this in like almost a year, so. Most of the way through that section, through that phase, rather. What new boss is this? What's this guy? Okay, that was not passable. I think I have to wait for that to get further down the tunnel before I hit it. You know it's bad when the zone music starts looping. We're having fun. I just want to give these, like... Oh, that's even better strat. Just don't kill them. Alright, that's... I like that strat. That's way easier. I don't need the points. This isn't a high score run. And I want Tiger for this boss, too. I just want to let you guys listen to that music more. And three bosses Tiger. This is the, this guy. And thanks, King Pan. I think I saw you say something earlier, like, what the hell is this? I think a lot of people are saying that. Because I've only ever streamed this game, I think, once or twice, so... And I don't know a single other person who owns it, so... Unless Punchy owns a copy. But I don't know about that. Monkey and then switch to Tiger. This is one of the harder zones, strictly because it's really hard to see everything with plain contrast to the background. You do have a copy of this game, oh sweet. Actually, it wouldn't have been that bad, but it wouldn't have been great. Alright, so clearly the strat is just to ignore these guys, so I'm gonna do that. It makes it way easier. Yeah, I checked, like, I was watching the video of my run, and it's from, like, 8 or 9 months ago, so. And 4D is Tiger, and then... This plus is tricky, it's hard to get in on him. Because of the spread of weapons. The spread of fire, though. I thought you were dead there, actually. Yeah. One thing you'll find watching this is Tiger is a little overpowered. And dying immediately on a boss is not a good strat. That segment's terrible. Yeah, you can get like some sort of like secret message at the end of the game if you collect all of the gray things that boss spits out, like all the numbers and all the characters. I just kill him because you know what's funny is I could still PB with this. Yeah, for real. Okay, 5B is monkey to tiger to monkey again. There are so many mid-bosses in this game, like, you don't even technically need to kill them, but it's way easier than having been spending the whole time dodging them. You know what I mean? I really shouldn't need to, like, remember my notes here. Or, like, have any notes, but I do. Once I do, like, another run. Like, after this run, I should hopefully not need notes. I hate this section. It's really, really hard to see these purple lasers when you kill these things. Okay, we made it. Like 5D, monkey into tiger. Section there, come on. I hit it. There we go. I have been killed by that, you know, revenge attack there. It's quite tragic. Alright, surprise, surprise. Tiger is the best weapon on this boss again. Who'da thunk it? Nice. And look at that, we are ahead. What a speed run. Alright, 6A, start with Tiger. Hey, because those are bossy right away here. Whoa. Okay, I totally got around that, even though I totally didn't pull it over. Yo, thanks, Sid. Alright, different weapon. Yeehaw. Most of these puzzles, I don't try and solve them because I don't actually know the solution. And you don't have to solve them, you just get points if you do manage to solve them. Wow, I'm good. It's actually the first time I've solved either of those puzzles ever. Yeah, this one I don't know how to solve either. No. No, it does not. Which is why I'm not even attempting to solve this puzzle. Because I can't be bothered. Really, the only thing that impacts your time is dying or not dying, and killing bosses quickly. Here, I need a weapon change. 6C, I go monkey. Where's monkey? There it is. For the Rubik's Cube here. The deadly Rubik's Cube. Now I go back to shoot. Section I keep sheep because I use it on the next boss. All right, this section is actually has, if I remember correctly, this section has no enemies and it's actually very hard because dodging all these spawning blocks is the end of this is very tricky. This right here is one of the trickier sections. And then the very, very end, you gotta squeeze through a super tight gap. If memory serves. Yeah, here, you gotta really, really squeeze through that. It's like the last platform. You get freaking screwed. Okay, so I have some strats for this boss here. nice. Switch to Tiger at the start of D&D. That's all this. This level has the hardest boss. So hopefully we can manage. In my first playthrough of this game, the final boss, or the boss in this level, took me like at least 30 minutes, I think. Section sucks too. If I remember, there's like a nasty bend in the tunnel. Yeah, right here. There's another one. I'm gonna go this way to get this one. Okay. And 7C is just straight monkey. Ooh, I almost hit that. That was very close. So here comes this awful boss, and I have a new strat here. So I used to use dog. It was the only place in the game I used dog. But I was watching some other people, you know, do their playthroughs of this game, and they were using bird here. So, and they were beating this boss like 30 seconds faster than I was. So I'm gonna use bird, and we'll see what happens. Thank you. Nice. Alright, Bird, definitely good on that boss. Oh, I'm not even getting bonus points here. He's got some banger music too. I looked away from the screen. That's entirely my fault. I had looked at my notes. I shouldn't have done that. I probably can't PB anymore. That's okay. Who cares? My PB actually does die on this stage, so maybe it's still possible. And I was 30 seconds ahead, so. Tiger the monkey. And after this run, I shouldn't need my notes anymore. So I barely even need them now. My boss is a huge pain if you don't kill him quickly. So use some erasers towards the end of this section, so that'll do just that. Another new weapon here. I'm gonna use horse on this boss. Maybe. I barely even hit the boss. There we go. I was not looking. I was trying to get to Tiger. I forgot that guy spawned platforms that killed you. Alright, well, definitely can't PB anymore. This is where my PB died, was fighting this guy. That might actually still be possible. So I do have some strats here. The strats do not involve dying. Alright, PB definitely dead now. It takes longer than 30 seconds to kill this boss. Oh my goodness, what an insane speedrun. Unbeatable world record, IMO. This is the pinnacle of PS1 shoot 'em up gameplay right there. Like, honestly, I don't think anyone can beat that time. That was so incredibly well played. Honestly, like, the new strats are OP, and I'm thinking, like, so on that last boss, I think I should just use horse the whole time, because, I mean, it clearly hits him quicker, so. And then we'll see, we'll have to do more runs to find out, that's for sure. High score?